Officials from the Uganda AIDS Commission have reported a rise in HIV/AIDS in the country, warning that if the laxity against the fight continues, the disease will claim more people in the country. They have reiterated a united call to fight the disease.
We are partnering with Amical because we were really looking at the urban centers, being that they are areas of high HIV prevalence. So we feel that by the time we have addressed most of the issues in the urban centers, it should be able to help us to reduce on the HIV prevalence that is in the urban centers.
They have tasked urban authorities to double the efforts in the fight against HIV/AIDS, and these can be fully achieved through stepping up sensitization campaigns, distribution of free condoms, fighting prostitution, and supporting women with startup capital for businesses, among others.
When you look at our HIV prevalence in the 80s, it was high, about 18%, and right now it has come down to about almost 5%, and that has been the work of the media. We know that we started out with Gwanga Muje, people would come and listen to radio stations and everything, but right now we feel that as we approach 2030, there is a need for reinvigorated communication.
When we talk about HIV, when we talk about productivity, when we talk about people being better, we need to start with the urban communities, and it will be replicated to the rural communities as well.
The Uganda AIDS Commission also highlighted the HIV cases in prisons, which have been attributed to sharing of objects by the inmates.
There is a community which has been neglected, and this is the prison community. The services that are in the community that we are aware of, people get their treatment, they ensure that they are adhering, but they are missing a link probably on the communication, what messages is given to the broader prison on HIV prevention and HIV programming in the whole. I don't see much of that happening in prison.
When they are entering prison, they are tested. But then to our shock, even somebody who entered negative, then they turn positive inside there. And when they go further to investigate, this morning he says it is mainly because of injecting drug use.
While the national HIV prevalence stands at 6.5%, that within prisons is at 13% for females and 11% for the males. Story compiled by Juliet Namuwaya for the news.